I just want black kids to dream beyond the limits of curiosity. I hope their imagination has them tumbling down rabbit holes and not the sidewalks they are chalked into. I never thought I'd have a life outside of my city. These red lines had me boxed in. What is life when everything around you wants you locked in a box, buried, gaping holes in family structures? That's why most everyone is mad here. With my trauma, I'm not all there myself. My smile fades like the Cheshire Cat following white rabbits. Their privilege left me in a world of trouble, living two lives. My teenage years was a tale of two cities. Dear God, your son destroyed the market inside a temple once. Now seeing the carpenter and walrus side by side leaves me confused. It's easy to spot the perversion and greed of the church. I mean the walrus who ate the rewards. They were working in tandem, but were never on the same team. The movie Alice in Wonderland was released in 1951, the book 1865, and today the problems are still the same. The rich abuse their power, and the church aligns with the rich, too busy pimping bread and butterflies while the bodies seek refuge in a garden, wondering how we got here in the first place. In this place where monsters live beside us, and 10/6 too closely resembles 3/5. My sister Kai saw early and left this place, keeping her temper. She planted seeds that she could only water with faith. I learned a lot from flowers, like how they always require more when they start with nothing. They need more water, more sun, more time. But who has time when trauma uproots you? When there are eyes watching your every move, waiting for you to slip up. There's a price to pay living a life without reason, without purpose. And if you grew up in the hood, you knew at any moment it could be off with your head. So then what holds you back? Is it your curiosity, anxiety, or fear? Assimilation forces you to adapt quickly. A chameleon in fancy clothes didn't make me an imposter. I read the classics, Homer, Shakespeare, Plato, Nietzsche, and Locke. But of all the dead white men in the poet society, I understood Edgar Allan Poe the best. As black people, we all do. We know all too well the feelings of despair that come from losing the people and things you love. So quote the raven, nevermore. I will never forget where I came from or how to find my way home. I miss everything, but I haven't lost anything. I carried hope with me when I left. I left my city for the adventure because one day I knew I'd have a story to bring back from beyond Wonderland. Pages filled with magic creatures, plot twists and turns, with my Queen of Hearts and two tickets to a happily ever after.